cardiovascular disease is the number one cause of death in women in the United States. And we looked at a nationally representative sample that represents 11 million women in the United States who are living with cardiovascular disease, and we looked at outcomes that the patients reported. And what we found is that there were significant gender disparities, that even after we took into account age and other health comorbidities, health problems, and other socioeconomic status, that women compared to men were more likely to report that their healthcare providers did not listen to them. They report that their healthcare providers didn't spend enough time with them, didn't respect them.
There's really not much talking about like the sociocultural aspect, talking about like communication, talking about like satisfaction and quality of life of men compared with women. Also, some of the well-established medications used for the management of cardiovascular disease, like aspirin, everyone knows about baby aspirin, or like statins, how this medication use varies between men versus women. So, also, women were also more likely to utilize, you know, the emergency room, and also more likely to be hospitalized, right? So what even makes this more interesting is that there's a mechanism, you know, for this is not known. Is it just a sociocultural thing? Is it something with presentation? Is it something with the physician? So what made this more interesting was that we had to like stratify based on the gender of the physician. What I'm trying to say is trying to compare if you had a male physician and you're a female patient, are you more likely to be on these medications, or are you more likely to have to report poor outcomes compared with if you had a female physician?
Overall, women patients with cardiovascular disease report a poor experience with their health care, and we think that this can translate to meaningful differences in these disparities in health outcomes for women, and that if we can improve and try to understand why there's these gender gaps in communication with healthcare providers, then hopefully this can be translated to improve outcomes for our women patients.